it up, dog. Fucking these guys up, man. Let's see you. Come on. Japan!
My first trip with him was the trip that Phil passed. Right after that happened, Jay came to me and he's like, our best friend just died. Don't worry because I got your back. From that trip on, he kind of became my mentor, older brother, whatever you want to call it. He was actually the one that gave me the fucking nickname, you know, the Butchers. So one day I go to Jake's office and he shows me a picture of crusty old skate park and he's like, this is Japan. It's like one of the oldest parks and we're going there. You want to come with us? And I'm like, sure, who's going? So Jake is like, so far we got Hewitt and we got Bailey going. And I was like, okay, so I'm gonna be the only street skater, but who cares, you know, let's go. Let's go to Japan, fuck it. I feel like the trip was like split in two parts.
Definitely our goal was fucking Mikasa. So anything on top of that was just the icing on the cake. And then Diego came through with all Diego fucking magic.
Tokyo was like such a crazy city, like so many people. You know, we were like renegades, going out, leaving the hotel and like street skating.
All right, dog, it's on.
Jake was just like going crazy, ollieing downstairs.
He was into all his stairs at that point.
Yeah, Felper.
Went to all his stairs. Cool, man.
So I knew there was like a big double set that I wanted to kind of look at. One of those days that we were like street skating and cruising around, we found the actual double set. Right around the corner, there was the Big 20. I looked at Jake and I'm like, dude, I think I can ollie this. So Jake is like, dude, if you do it, this is the cover that we're looking for. Knowing that we had like 10 more days on the trip, I told him like, we should just save it maybe for the last day.
That was Diego's time to explore.
Diego's skating was so rad. It was like, let me go to this handrail and let me do like 7 tricks down it. Capture all of it multiple times, like Super 8, a couple angles. Luke's got all of his shit.
So we were just kind of like cruising around, you know, getting kicked up from one spot, going to the next one. Jake was like a fucking street maniac, eating shit like nonstop.
It was another fucking damn Jake goofing off.
That'd be a sick one.
Where?
Right there.
So I was trying to get him to do the Stacy Peralta.
I like it. So shove it. Come on.
We get Park Barrick on this fourth flag.
Oh, you fit. You must.
I wanted him to get that heel flip.
It was like the sickest thing to just see him street skating.
Yeah.
Because I was more used to like seeing him skate in parks. I think he seriously tried to ollie this little double set. Like he was like going for it.
Did he ollie it? Did he make it?
Kicked out.
Just seeing Jake go for a double set, you're like, okay, I have to try it now. So that might have fired Diego up a little bit.
Frontside 360 down like full double set. I mean, that was like insane to see. Dude, Diego was warrior status, man.
Rail slide.
Where? Down there, meathead. Is that good?
When it came down to like skating pools and the skate parks, those guys were just fun to watch. Sit down, have my camera on, and film him skating. You
know? Yes! Ready, left! Yes! Oh my God!
Watching those guys skate transition was like the best thing ever. Every single day that we were on the trip, I was just like thinking about that one set.
It was like, you know, people were coming stairs at the start. No one at all, I did 20 set stairs. I didn't know how that was gonna react. Break both of his fucking legs.
And I think it's really shitty ground, dude. It's like tile. It's like stuff you don't want to slam off of flying down 20 fucking staircase down in the air and then slide out on.
Long story short, like the last day of the trip, we got up at 7, we had breakfast, and I was just like, let's go, dude, it's go time, like Jake said. So we all went there. Peter like got his camera set up.
I was filming it from way far away. I'm kind of shaking. I didn't know what I was doing.
Bailey was like filming Super 8.
Dude, that was pretty heavy.
This is like in the middle of like the financial area. So it was so hard to skate it because it was like the landing, it's like right in front of like the main entry of the building. But Jake was like standing right there and he was like, dude, you got it, you got it. You know, it was like 8 in the morning, ready to do it. So went first try, jumped off. I was like, I got it, dude. It's big, but I got it.
Oh, Jimmy.
Second try, I think I landed on it, kind of like bounced off, and then it was like 2 or 3 more tries. Going.
And then he landed it. That was like flying. And the fucking axle bent. And he shows the truck. And he says like, Valor!
Valor!
His truck is like bent, like partially broken. It's like Cardiel's 360 at fucking Marseille on the broken board, dude. Like, how did you do that, dude?
Peter actually filmed it really good. I was like stoked when I saw the footage of it.
I've never filmed anything like this before. Jake was just like, yeah, of course he did it. That's what we brought him here for.
Jake was like dancing around. Having Jake at the spot was always like an extra push. He was like such a good motivation when it came down to doing tricks. You know, he was always like, I know you got it. The scream of Hewitt when I made it, Diego, that was like the best feeling ever.
Diego! Yeah!
Valor.
To me, Jake is like one of the most important people in my life.
DJ Phillips, he is the one.
Every day, basically, I think of him and like all the stuff that he taught me.
Got it, Jake.
Like this. Ha! Label kills.
Who's that?
Scott Bourne.
He was like Mr. Thrasher at that time. I mean, he still is, I think. Like, there's no replacement for him.
What you doing?